underestimated the impact the announcement would make, and it was all about what would happen if you cloned human beings, not sheep. So it was something we had prepared for, but we'd been totally overwhelmed by the response. Had not anticipated such a sort of severe and universal response at the time.
Yeah, when Dolly was announced, she made global headlines and raised fears of a dystopian future of clone armies and even resurrecting the dead. 20 years on, we know for certain that never happened. So how has the technology been used over the years?
Well, it's been used in sort of really a niche-like way. It's been used to propagate elite domestic animals so that you could breed more offspring by making more, if you like, founders. So you could replicate the number of identical clone, in fact, say, bulls and cows to enable much greater numbers of offspring. And it's been used to try and reestablish ancient breeds and things like that. And it still is in use that way. But for me, the greatest legacy was the resurgence of interest and in scientists in trying to reprogram the genome to try and take adult cells, which were fixed, if you like, in their ways, and restore them to the pristine naive state that you find in embryonic cells, and take advantage of that type of transformation.
And that's the technical and scientific legacy of Dolly. And as you mentioned earlier, just the cloning technology has been used to clone a number of species, you know, from horses to household pets. Is the technology there to clone a human, but we are prevented from doing so because of ethical concerns?
We're prevented from doing so by both ethical and legal concerns. I mean, in many countries, it's banned with the threat of criminal prosecution. It's also technically, the whole cloning process remains very technically difficult. And we're still not absolutely certain it could be performed with humans. What we do know is that some of the earlier stages of the technique have been successfully used with human cells. But we do know that no one's been able to properly clone non-human primates like monkeys. So we're still not sure we could, even if we wanted to.